Married 911 operator is caught in a cop sex scandal, and damn it, this gets deep. Let's put the picture up full mass. The hell is going on in these police departments? Krystle Perez, married Texas 911 dispatcher at San Antonio's Bexar County Sheriff's Department, faces termination after she was allegedly caught sexting seven. She was sexting seven cops, having affairs with at least two others. Ms. Perez has been placed on leave over the sleazy messages, which saw her speak with both sergeant and deputy at length about alleged past tryst. Other messages sent by Perez, 38, and uncovered by her husband, Mr. Perez, 41, contain equally sexed up correspondence between her and four other officers employed by the force, as well as a cop at a nearby department. Now, it's unfair for her to be the face of this story. Let's put up the other faces in this story. You got Deputy Juan Leal has been placed on unpaid leave, and Deputy Jason Jarvis has been hit with a 30-day suspension. Damn! They would have been better off as far as penalty if they shot an unarmed citizen. Now, I'm going to explain in just a moment why this is problematic for everybody. Let's go to Sergeant Ronaldo Solanas, who has been placed on leave without pay also. All right? Salinas, Lil, Perez have all been warned by the county sheriff's office that they are likely to lose their jobs. They denied misbehaving while on duty, but the sheriff is now investigating to see whether this is true. Messages sent to Salinas suggest he and Ms. Perez met up for sex while Jarvis's wife, who's now divorcing him, said he admitted an affair to her. We got the screenshots. Put them up. Text messages. That's called receipts. Okay? Those are receipts. Let's put up the husband, Mr. Perez. All right. He said, and I quote, keep his picture up. She was the love of my life, and it was very distraught, heartbreaking. 41-year-old Giancarlo told KABB San Antonio over the weekend of how his marriage imploded last December when he discovered the text on his wife's phone. I was in disbelief, he says in the clip, and at one point even appeared on the verge of retching as he recalled the traumatic discovery. Listen, man, I can't imagine. I cannot imagine, okay? He knew some of these folks. I can't imagine. But let's be very clear why this is important for the public and for the community, period. Let's say something happens. Let's say you have to hold an officer accountable because they misstepped. They committed a criminal violation. They violated the civil rights of another human being. Let's say that happened, right? If that happened, who do you think sudden everybody's compromised when people should be held accountable? And a decision has to be made. Am I going to hold the person that I'm already committing this act with accountable, or shut up, lie on the report, let it pass so it doesn't blow back on me? That is the problem. That is the public dynamic that has to be checked. These inappropriate relationships lead to a bad outcome for citizens who require transparency for the system of law enforcement to operate for them. Sharon, thoughts on this?
I thought I worked at some wild places. I just don't even... What is going on with these people and these places and these full frontal, well, confessions? I don't know that I would want to digest this publicly.
Yeah, there you go. All right. You know, what else can you say?